Honorable Martha, thank you so much for making time for us. How do you remember President Moi?
I remember him as a human being, as a very sociable person, as I came to know him much later. But I also remember him in my youthful days and in my early days as a politician, as an iron-fisted leader who did not want any opposition, who did not guide the country according to democratic tenets. Actually, my entry into politics was as a young lawyer resisting the advances of Moi to run the Law Society of Kenya. So he had two faces. And even as a leader, I remember his passion for education. I think his greatest legacy, as far as I'm concerned, is in pushing education, having more universities and all that. But I also remember him for detaining those who are opposed to him, for hounding those opposed to him. And more significantly now, on a positive note, I think that he did the right thing to hand over power peacefully, therefore setting the stage for peaceful passing on of power in Kenya. That was in 2002, and a tradition we must continue with.
And Honorable Karua, you were the first female to be voted as an MP under the multi-partyism dispensation. What was it like at that time, being a woman and being in the opposition in that political atmosphere?
I'll first say I wasn't the only one, because we came in with Charity Ngilu, with Mary Wanjiru, and with veterans like Phoebe Asio and Agnes Detey. We were six of us. So I wasn't the only one, but I can tell you it was tough. We came in and we were not even greeting each other with the people on the other side, channel. And for the president, whenever he went to public spaces where there would be leaders, he never acknowledged the opposition, which led to my walkout of his function in Kirinyaga one, when he denied me a chance to address the people and also to rebut the unpalatable things his people were saying about the opposition and about my then party leader, the retired President Moi Kibaki. So yeah. Moi had two faces, his face as a leader, ruling with an iron fist, and very unaccommodative. But you meet him on a personal level, a totally different person, very sociable. I met him on several occasions, once as a member of parliament, when the late Lotodo died and I went to Lotodo's funeral, and we chatted. Then I met him when we had the IPPG group and we went to State House to report to him. And thereafter, as a minister of government, I went several times to his cabernet garden's home to brief him on the negotiations during the National Accord negotiations.
All right.
So he's a very social person at a personal level. And I know Kenya has lost a leader who very many people remember fondly. And as leaders, we complained about the Moi era. But when given the chance, many have behaved in a manner that is exactly the same or worse.
Right.
And I know that he is a mentor to many in politics. He is literally the political father of the current President Uhuru Kenyatta and even his deputy and many others.
All right. So, Honorable Gishugu, Honorable Martha Karua, you're the Gishugu MP at that time in 2001. And in Kerugoya, you actually walked out on him because some local chairman there spoke against the opposition. And you say that he was an iron-fisted leader. Should leaders take responsibility for what their foot soldiers say?
Yes, because I actually approached him and told him, I was seated next to him. I told him he has to give me time to rebut what is being said.
Yeah.
Because it is wrong for them to berate the opposition. And he just said that he wouldn't say the things his people are saying, but then he didn't stop them, nor did he give me a chance. I think any leader And including today, when you are in a meeting and your juniors do things you don't approve of, you should actually come out publicly and say this is not the way. Whether it is intolerance of throwing people out of meetings, or whether it's name calling, any leader who sits while there's truth to the name calling is responsible. And I've said so before.
But if the detentions were so rampant, were you not afraid that you'd be detained as well? Because that was essentially disrespecting the president.
I was not disrespecting. I was actually exercising. That is the problem we have in Kenya, interpreting, you know, individual choices. Walking out of a presidential meeting is not, it may be disrespect in a way, but respect is a two-way traffic. He disrespected the opposition and myself who were present with his troops. It was a show of disagreement and defiance, which the law entitles me to. I chose not to listen to him because they wouldn't listen to me. Also.
Now,
as a lawyer, I knew that I had the right to do so.
And you mentioned that he was the political father of many who are in office today. Are there any qualities that leaders today can draw from him in a positive sense, as much as he was a polarizing figure?
I think that everybody has a positive side. Whenever the country reached a boiling point, Moi always seemed to retreat and to give space for people to talk. If you remember during the repeal of Section 2A, initially they had said that Kenya will never return to multi-party. But he did lead his troops to allow the multi-party. If it is the handing over in 2002, they should learn to gauge the mood of the people and to know when to retreat, something people don't seem to learn.
In hindsight, when you compare now his style of leadership and people today, people complain that there was some sense of dictatorship, but there are others who say that is what the country needed at that time. What do you say to those people?
The country will never need dictatorship. Let people be free, but a leader can be firm. Firm with the rule of law.
Yeah.
Firm within the law, but not firm outside the law. And what we are seeing is a mixture of the rule of law and sometimes things that are outside the law. We need to stick to the rule of law.
All right.
The looting that has occurred without being stopped, but luckily now our president has declared war on corruption. So if we had been consistent, we could have saved Kenyans a lot of misery.